Dear students, assalamu alaikum. Our today's lecture is about parts of speech. I have again offered you the grammar books Renan Martin High School, Renan Martin Primary, and Renan Martin Middle. According to these books, the authentic definitions and the understandable definitions of parts of speech will be explained to you. But first, I will give you whatever I have researched for you so that parts of speech become basically easy for you and easy to understand for you. This is part one of parts of speech. Another part will be uploaded in a little while. Let's start with what basically parts of speech is. Now, what is speech? Speech is the conversation that we make in a language, especially at the moment we're talking about English language. So whatever statements we give or whatever sentences are formed, the things that make up the constitution of a sentence is known as parts of speech. Parts of speech are the basic requirements of sentence making and understanding. Now, words are divided into different kinds or classes called parts of speech according to their use, that is, according to the work they do in a sentence. Now, this definition is very elaborate. It says that a sentence is made up of many parts, and these parts join together in a chain and make up a sentence that is easily understandable and comprehensible, and each part gives a different function from the other. And these parts together make up a proper sentence. Sentence makes up paragraphs and so on and so forth. The parts of speech are 8 in number. The English language has 8 parts of speech. The first one is noun, then verb, pronoun, adverb, adjective, prepositions, conjunctions, and interjections. In this first part explanation, I'll give you a small definition of each part and their examples and explanations. Now, the first basic one that we start with is the noun. A noun is a naming word. It is the name of a person, place, thing, or idea. The word thing is used to mean anything that we can think of. Now, for me, I think noun is the basic identification of anything that is around us. The name that we give to that object which is around us. It can be a living object or non-living or anything. Any name that is given to that particular object is a noun. For example, Ali is a proper noun. Now, you give certain persons certain proper names, definite names, and they are all known as proper nouns. Boy is a common noun. Pakistan is a proper noun. Country is a common noun. Now, what is the difference between a proper and a common noun? A name given to different objects which are more than one in number, and there is no particular identification of that object, that name is known as a common noun. And when you give a particular identification to a person, place, or thing, that noun is known as a proper noun. Now, we will discuss a few types of nouns over here. Common noun, boy, girl, city, car. Proper noun, Karachi, Ali, Toyota, any name that is definite. Collective noun, fleet, one word used for a group of people, a group of things, a group of objects is known as a collective noun. For example, fleet, crowd, army. A fleet of sheep, a crowd of ships, a crowd of people, an army of men. Abstract noun, honesty, bravery, hatred. Now, abstract nouns are the nouns that cannot be touched. They do not have any physical appearance, but they can only be felt. Countable and uncountable nouns. Next, we move on to the noun gender, which is masculine and feminine. Boy, girl, man, woman. These names, when they are distributed in their gender form, they are known as masculine and feminine. Second part of parts of speech is verb. A verb is a word that tells what someone or something does. It is an action word or word of being. For example, sit, laugh, run, jump, is, am, was, or were. Now, in verbs, whenever an action is going on and the word describes the action, that word is known as a verb. Now, verb of being is also an important part of it, and that is known as a helping verb or the auxiliary verb. Suppose I say I am a teacher. So I am the subject. Am is your auxiliary verb or the verb of being that explains my being, and the work that I do is I teach. So I am a teacher. Next is pronoun. A pronoun is a word used in place of a noun. When we are talking to somebody or we are writing about someone, if we constantly repeat that person's name, it looks a little, it sounds and looks and is very odd. So, in order to stop that constant repetition, grammar has given us a word which is known as a pronoun. For example, he, she, it, they, you, and we. Next, we come on to the fourth part of the parts of speech, which is an adverb. An adverb is a word which describes an action. It is a word added to a verb to modify its meaning. It can also at times modify adjectives and other adverbs. It tells you when, where, how, in what manner, or to what extent an action is performed. Many end in ly. Now, many end in ly. Keep that in mind, but not always. It's not always that all words that end in ly are adverbs. For example, fast, never, now, neatly, carefully, happily. When they are describing a verb, then those words are known as adverbs. For example, I write neatly. Now, the action that I do is write, and how I do it is neatly. So, neatly is the word which describes the verb, and here neatly is known as an adverb. The fifth part of parts of speech is an adjective. An adjective is a word used to modify or describe a noun. For example, happy, sad, red, green, fat. Now, she is a happy girl. She is a girl. But if I want to explain her condition, I will write, she is a happy girl. Sad, he is a sad boy. He is a good boy. He is a naughty boy. This is a red book. This is a red pencil. Her shirt is red. Her shirt is being described by the color red. Green, Pakistan flag is green and white. Green and white both are explaining the color of the Pakistan flag. Fat, his cat is very fat. Now we are explaining the cat and are telling everyone that the cat is fat. Sixth part of your parts of speech is prepositions. A preposition is a word placed before a noun or a pronoun to show its location or direction. It may also show a noun or pronoun's relationship to some other word in the sentence. Now, some of the prepositions are to, with, in, by, from. I'll give you sentences to explain it further. The cat is sitting on the table. Now here, the cat is the subject or the noun. Is sitting is doing an action, and where that action is taking place is on the table. Next is, I am going home with my mother. I am the subject. I am going. Am is the helping word. My action is going. Where am I going? I'm going with my mother. With whom am I going? With is the connection between one noun, my action, and the other noun. Next is in. The book is in the cupboard. The book is the subject. The book is the helping word, is in the cupboard. Now, where is the book? The book is in the cupboard. The seventh part of parts of speech is conjunctions. Now, the word conjunctions means joining. The literal meaning of the word conjunctions is joining. A conjunction is a word used to connect other words, phrases, clauses, or acts as a joining word to join two small sentences. Basically, conjunctions means joining. This is a joining word which either joins two phrases, two clauses, or two smaller sentences to make a complex sentence. Some of the conjunctions are and, but, or, etc. There are many other. When we go into the detail of conjunctions, then we are going to discuss it more. The eighth part of the parts of speech are interjections. These are words that express strong or sudden emotions. And you have to have an exclamation mark at the end of the interjection. The examples given here are, oh dear, wow, ouch, hurrah, so sad. These exclamations are expressions which are uncontrollable and spur of the moment, which come out immediately at the sight of extreme happiness or extreme sadness. Now, I'll go again to the beginning. What are parts of speech and why are they required? They are required to understand the proper functioning of each word which joins together to make a complete sentence. Now, beginning of a word is the alphabet. There are 26 alphabets in the English language. By joining these alphabets, we make up words. By joining up these words, we make up sentences. For understanding of these sentences, we need parts of speech, which are 8 in number, and these explain how the action was taking place, what the subject was doing. By explaining the subject, that is the noun, by explaining the action, by adding adverbs to it, by making sentences elaborate, by giving a complete description, all these descriptions are only given with the help of parts of speech, which make it easy to understand and also to note that what is going on in each word of a complete sentence. The most important thing is the first word of the sentence should be written with a capital letter, and there should be a full stop, a question mark, or an exclamation mark at the end of the sentence. These are basic requirements. I hope you have understood what I have given to you today in parts of speech. This is part 1 of your lecture. Part 2 and 3 of parts of speech will be sent to you in a little while. Please like and subscribe our channel. Thank you.